statement of a spokesman for the National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. We have already warned the South Korean group of traders not to make reckless remarks concerning the sinking of the warship Chunan of the South Korean Puppet Navy. Nevertheless, the group of traders have far-fetchedly tried to link the case with us without offering any material evidence. They finally announced the results of the investigation, which assert that the warship was sunken by a torpedo attack in a bid to mislead the public opinion inside and outside Korea. They are at the same time crying for punishment and retaliation internally and foolishly seeking to pour the international community into applying additional sanctions against the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. What matters is that traitor Lee Myung-bak is taking the lead in such anti-DPRK smear campaign, even daring slander the headquarters of our revolution. Meanwhile, Kim Tae-yong and other gangsters of the South Korean puppet military, accustomed to flattery and blind obedience, echo Lee Myung-bak's outbursts. This smear campaign is fanned by Lee Myung-hwan and other ultra-rightist conservatives of South Korea. This is also joined by the US and Japanese aggressors who are making desperate efforts to keep their hostile policy towards the DPRK on its orbit. We would like to question them for better linking the above said case with the DPRK, why they don't link with it the death of a puppet army soldier, crashes of fighter plane and township of the puppet navy and air force, and the sinking of a civilian fishing boat that occurred one after another almost simultaneously. It is an age of science and technology. As a swollen balloon is bound to break, any lie is bound to be brought to light, no matter how hard one may try to make it sound plausible. What is evident is that the sinking of warship Chunan can never be construed otherwise than a conspiratorial farce and charade deliberately orchestrated by the group of traitors to achieve certain political and military aims, because only 46 soldiers met miserable death while officers survived the case. This being a hard reality, they are pointing a dirty accusing finger at us like a thief trying to stop the thief. It is a trite method of the successive South Korean puppet regimes to fake up a shocking case and use it for floating a story about a north wind whenever they find themselves in a crisis. These days, they are using for this plot even deserters from the north and human scouts who have found a way to a dumping ground. The National Defense Commission of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, responsible for the defense of the country and the security of the nation, clarifies the principal stand of our army and people in view of the grave situation where the sinister plot of the group of traitors may lead to reckless actions against us. 1. As the group of traitors declared that the sinking of the warship Chunan is linked with us, the National Defense Commission of the DPRK will dispatch an inspection group to the spot of South Korea to verify material evidence concerning the linkage. The group should produce before the dignified inspection group of the DPRK material evidence proving that the sinking of the warship is linked with us. We remind the group of traders in advance that there should be not a shred of doubt about the material evidence to be produced before the inspection group. 2. Our army and people will promptly react to any punishment and retaliation and to any sanctions infringing upon our state interests with various forms of tough measures, including an all-out war. The all-out war to be undertaken by us will be a secret war involving the whole nation, all the people, and the whole state, for completely eliminating the strongholds of the group of traitors who orchestrated a conspiratorial farce and charade and their followers, and building instead a reunified power in which the whole nation emerges powerful and prosperous. The tough retaliatory measures to be taken by us will prove to be just practical actions for dealing unpredictable sledgehammer blows at a group of traitors to block national reconciliation and unity and stir up an atmosphere of confrontation in the South Korean society. 3. Now that a group of traders declared what it called a decisive action, they'll brand any small incident that occurs in the territorial waters, air and territory where our sovereignty is exercised, including the West Sea of Korea, as the provocation of confrontation damage and reacted with unlimited retaliatory blow, mostly strong fiscal blow. It is our invariable iron will to react to retaliation with more powerful retaliation and to punishment with indiscriminate punishment of our style. Availing ourselves of this opportunity, we strongly warn the U.S. and Japanese authorities and reflect their correlations to act with discretion. The world will clearly see what dear price the clever traders will have to pay for having faced the clumsy conspiratorial force and charade the stifled compatriots. Pyongyang, May the 20th, 2099 or 2010.